Hello everyone and welcome to Learn Services. In this video I will talk about General Studies, means GK. GK question paper of CDS 2 2018 with the answer key. Okay. So let's see the question paper. Sorry. So the first question is, two reactants in a flask at room temperature are producing bubbles of a gas that turn lime water milky. Okay. So lime water turns milky. Okay. The reactants could be, so right option is B, magnesium carbonate and hydrochloric acid. Okay. Second question is, how many moles of CO can be obtained by reacting 2 mole of CH4 with 2 mole of O2 according to the equation given below, CH4 plus half O2 equal to CO plus 2H2. So right option is 2.0. Okay. Reaction between which of the following two reactants will produce hydrogen gas? Okay. So right option at here is magnesium and hydrochloric acid. Next question is, which of the following characteristic is common to hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide? So options are, they are all diatomic, they are all gases at room temperature, they are all colored, they all have same reactivity. So right option is they are all gases at room temperature. The compound C7H7NO2 has, so I'm going to tell you right option is they have 17 atoms in a molecule of the compound. Which of the following is the general formula for saturated hydrocarbon? Okay, so this is very simple question and its right answer will be CnH2n+2, alkane. Next question is, a particle moves with a uniform acceleration along a straight line from rest. The percentage increase in displacement during 6th second compared to that in 5th second is about. So you have to solve this question and right answer is 22%. If two miscible liquids of same volume but different densities P1 and P2, also called as rho1 and rho2, are mixed, then density of the mixture is given by. So right option for this answer will be P1 plus P2 upon 2. This is simple average. The position vector of a particle is r equal to 2t square x cap plus 3 2y plus 4z. Then the instantaneous velocity v and acceleration a respectively lie. So right option for this question is on xy plane and along x direction. Okay. Two persons are holding a rope of negligible mass horizontally. A 20 kg mass is attached to the rope to the midpoint. As a result, the rope deviates from the horizontal direction. The tension required to completely straighten the rope is. So right option for this question is 200 Newton. Next question is, which one of the following does not convert electrical energy into light energy? Obviously, this is a very simple question. So a candle. Candle is not converting electrical energy into light energy. Okay. Actually, this is converting chemical energy into light energy, because candle is not having, no electricity. Like light emitting diode, laser or television set. Okay. Next question is, which of the following are the main absorbing organ of plants? So right option is root and leaf only. It's not bark. Bark is not absorbing any organ. Which of the following is not a primary function of green leaf? So options are manufacture of food, interchange of gases, evaporation of water, conduction of food and water. So right option is conduction of food and water. This is not the function of green leaf. Which one of the following denotes a true fruit? So right option is when only the thalamus of the flower grows and develops into a fruit. Okay, so this is denotes the true fruit. Okay. In which one of the following physiological process, excess water escapes in the form of droplets from a plant? Okay. So right option is transpiration. Sorry. In the xylem of a plant, If the xylem of a plant is mechanically blocked, which of the following functions of the plant will be affected? So, its transport of water and solutes. Which one of the following agents does not contribute to propagation of plants through seed dispersal? So, right option is fungus. The visible portion of electromagnetic spectrum is the visible portion. So, this is kind of simple question. So, light is the visual portion of electromagnetic spectrum. And now the question of real general knowledge starts. Which of the following is the correct ascending sequence of states in terms of their population density as per census 2011? So, right answer for this question is B. Arunachal Pradesh density is very low, then Mizoram, then Sikkim, then Himachal Pradesh. Okay, this is a tricky question. Many people can get confused with that. But Arunachal Pradesh obviously goes first. Then after you have to pick the Mizoram. Mizoram comes first, then Sikkim. Okay. The rate of population growth during 2001 to 2011 decade declined over the previous decade 1991-2001 in all of the following states except. So right option is Kerala. Actually in Kerala, it didn't decline. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following statements with regard to growth of coral reefs is not correct? So, coral can grow abundantly in fresh water. This is not correct actually. Coral can grow abundantly in fresh water. It requires warm water between 23-25 degrees centigrade. This is the right option. Obviously, coral can grow. It requires shallow salt water, not deeper than 50 meters. Okay. It requires plenty of sunlight to aid photosynthesis. Okay. So, what is not correct? Coral can grow abundantly in fresh water. Okay. It needs lime water. Okay. Sorry. It needs salt water. Okay. Sorry. As per census 2011, the concentration of scheduled caste population going by percentage of scheduled caste population to total population of the state is the highest in the state of. So, right option is A. Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is having highest population of scheduled caste. Which one of the following states has more than two major ports? So, right option for this option is D. Tamil Nadu. Okay, Tamil Nadu have more than two major ports. Next question is, the equivalent weight of BaOH ka whole twice is given atomic weight of Ba is 137.3. So, the equivalent weight of BaOH whole twice is? So, you have to solve this question. It's a simple one. You already have atomic weight of Ba, so you can put value of O and H and you will get the right option. And right option is 85.7. According to me, its right answer should be 171.3 because you know OH, H 1 ho gaya, O ka kitna ho gaya 16 plus 117, 17 to the 34 and you have to add 34 in 137 and that will become 171.3. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following nitrogen oxides has the highest oxidation state of nitrogen? So, right option for this question is D, N2O5. Which one of the following is not true for the form of carbon known as diamond? So, it is harder than graphite. That's true. It contains the same percentage of carbon as graphite. So, this is also right. It is better electric conductor than graphite. No, it is not a good electric conductor than graphite. It is better thermal conductor than graphite, not electric conductor. So, C option must be not true. It has a different carbon to carbon distance in all directions. Obviously true. In which one of the following reactions, the maximum quantity of H2 gas is produced by the decomposition of 1 gram of compound by H2O2. Okay. In which one of the following reactions the maximum quantity of H2 gas is produced by the decomposition of 1 gram of compound by H2O and O2. Okay. Right option for this question is A. CH4 plus H2O equal to CO plus 3H2. Okay. When a convex lens produces a real image of an object, this is a simple question. Real image. The minimum distance between the object and image is equal to get the real image. So the option is C, 4 times the focal length of the convex lens. Direction of magnetic field at any location. Direction of magnetic field at any location on the Earth's surface is commonly specified in terms of. Direction of magnetic field at any location on the Earth's surface is commonly specified in the terms of. So right option is C, both field declination and field inclination. Okay. A circuit has a fuse having a rating of 5 ampere. What is the maximum number of 100 watt and 220 volt bulbs that can be safely connected in parallel in the aircraft, in the circuit? So right option is C, 11. Next question is, which one of the following can extinguish fire from fire more quickly? Which of the following can extinguish fire more quickly? So right option is B, boiling water. Remember this is a very important thing. In which of the following heat loss is primarily not due to convection? Heat loss is primarily not due to convection. So right option is D, heating of glass surface of a bulb due to current in filament. So not due to convection, and rest are boiling water, land, sea breeze, circulation of air around glass. Obviously these are convection thing. Okay. Which of the following features is an indication of modification of stem of a plant? So right option is presence of eye on potato. Okay. Next question is, which of the following roles are played by epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicles, and prostate in male reproductive system of human? Okay. So right option is C, spermatogenesis and motility of sperms. Which of the following is the special type of milk produced by lactating mother, essential for the development of immune response of newborn baby in human? So right option is C, colostrum. Which of the following statements explain higher mutation rate and faster evolution found in RNA virus? So right option is, virus can multiply only within the living cell of a host. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following is the correct ascending sequence of states with regard to percentage of urban population by 2011 census? So right option for this question is B, first Goa. You have to tell ascending sequence. Goa, then Mizoram, then Maharashtra, and then Kerala. Okay. Which one of the following places does not fall on leeward slope? So option is, right option is D, Mangaluru. Okay. Next question is, South Arcot and Ramanthapuram receive over 50% of their annual rainfall from which one of the following? So, southwest monsoon, northeast monsoon, Bay of Bengal branch of summer monsoon, western disturbances. So right option is, right option is northeast monsoon. Okay. The 8 degree channel, this is very simple question. 8 degree channel separates which of the following? India and Sri Lanka, Lakshadweep and Maldives, Andaman and Nicobar, Indira Point and Indonesia. So right option for this question is Lakshadweep from Maldives. Actually it's a Minicao Island and Maldives. Okay, Minicao Island of Lakshadweep. Okay. Next question is match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer. Okay. So classification of town is there and example is given over there. So I am going to tell you the right answer. Right answer for this question is A. Means industrial town. Example of industrial town is Bhilai. Transport town, Vishakhapatnam. Mining town, Singrauli. And garrison cantonment town, Ambala. Okay. Next question is, which of the following statements with regard to the land use situation in India is correct? So you have to tell the right answer. Okay. So let's see. There has been a tremendous decline in area under forest in recent years. Yeah, you can say that. The rate of increase in land use in recent years is the highest in case of area under non-agriculture use. No. Land use such as barren and wasteland area under pastures and tree crops have experienced decline in recent years. No, this is not true. So right option is A, A1 only. Okay. There has been a tremendous decline in area under forest in recent years. Which one of the following was not a part of strategies followed by the government of India to increase food grain production in India immediately after independence? So right option for this question is C. Using high yielding variety seeds. So it was not followed immediately after independence. Actually it followed later on during the Green Revolution. Intensification of cropping over already cultivated land, obviously. Increasing cultivable area by bringing cultivable and fallow land under plow. Switching over from cash crops to food crops. So this was used, but this was not used after just after independence. It was used later on during Green Revolution. Okay. Which one of the following is a west flowing river? So you have to tell the right answer. Right answer for this question is D. Narmada. Narmada is west flowing river. Rest are east flowing river like Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna. Okay. Khasi language is included in. So Khasi language is included in. Right option for this question is B. Mon Khmer branch of Austroasiatic subfamily. Okay. Mon Khmer branch of Austroasiatic subfamily. So this is Khasi language is included in Mon Khmer branch of Austroasiatic subfamily. Okay. Next question is the headquarters of Metro Railway Zone is located in. So right option for this question is Kolkata. Headquarter of Metro Railway Zone is located in Kolkata. Which one among the following is not a tributary of River Luni? Oh, this is a very important question. And right answer for this question is Banas. Banas is not a tributary and rest are tributary of Luni, Khari, Sukri and Jawai. These are the tributary of Luni. Okay. Many people might have committed the mistake in this question. Next question is match list 1 with list 2 and these are major dams and states. This is a very important question. So let's take the right answer for this question. Right answer for this question is D. So Cheruthoni Dam is located in Kerala. Indira Sagar Dam is located in Madhya Pradesh. Krishna Raj Sagar Dam is located in the Karnataka. And Metro Dam is located in the Tamil Nadu. So these are very important questions you need to remember about the dams. Like Cheruthoni Dam is located in Kerala. Indira Sagar Dam is located in Madhya Pradesh. Krishna Raj Sagar Dam is located in the Karnataka. Metro Dam is located in the Tamil Nadu. Okay. Next question is, which among the following union territories of India shares the shortest length of national highway? Shortest length of national highway. So right option for this question is दादरा एंड नगर हवेली. ओके, शॉर्टेस्ट लेंथ ऑफ नेशनल हाईवे दादरा एंड नगर हवेली. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच वन एमंग द फॉलोइंग पासेस लिंक्स लासा विद लद्दाख. लासा विद लद्दाख. सो राइट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ए लानक ला. ओके, लानक ला. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली, यू मस्ट नो अबाउट दिस. लासा विद लद्दाख इज कनेक्ट विद द लानक ला पास. मेनी पीपल माइट हैव कमिटेड दिस मिस्टेक, मेनी पीपल माइट नॉट हैव इवन हर्ड अबाउट लानक ला पास. ओके, सो लासा विद लद्दाख इज कनेक्ट विद द लानक ला, लानक ला पास. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द लेटेस्ट रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया स्टडी ऑन स्टेट फाइनेंसेज कैपिटल स्पेंडिंग इज मैक्सिमम ऑन. सो इट इज मैक्सिमम ऑन अर्बन डेवलपमेंट. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द वर्ल्ड बैंक्स डूइंग बिजनेस रिपोर्ट 2018 इंडियाज रैंकिंग हैज इंप्रूव्ड इन 2018 एज कंपेयर टू 2017 इन विच आर द फॉलोइंग एरियाज. सो यू हैव टू टेल द एरियाज इन विच इंडियाज रैंक हैव इंप्रूव्ड. सो राइट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज वन एंड टू ओनली. सो पेइंग टैक्सेस, इन पेइंग टैक्सेस इंडियाज कंडीशन इंप्रूव्ड एंड इन रिजॉल्विंग इनसॉल्वेंसी इंडियाज कंडीशन इंप्रूव्ड. But in starting a business, India's condition deteriorated, and getting electricity, India's condition have not improved so much. Okay. 14th Finance Commission. 14th Finance Commission assigned different weights to the following parameters for distribution of tax proceeds to the state. Options are income distance, population, demographic changes, area. So you have to arrange the aforesaid parameters in descending order in terms of their weight. So in terms of their weight, you have to arrange in the descending order. So which comes first? So you have to tell this. Okay, so income distance comes first. Okay, and then it comes population, and then it comes area, and then it comes demographic changes. So 1, 2, 4, and 3. First comes income distance, then comes population, then comes area, and then demographic changes. Okay. Next question is the natural rate of unemployment. Natural rate of unemployment hypothesis was advocated by, and was advocated by Milton Friedman. Okay. Next question is the Harappan site at Kot Dizi is close to which one of the following major sites of that civilization. The Harappan site at Kot Dizi is close to which one of the following major sites of that civilization. So right option for this question is B, Mohenjo-daro. The story Gandatindu Jatak was written by in which language? So Gandatindu Jatak Jatak was written in which language? It was written in the language of Pali. According to Tamil Sangam text, who among the following were the large landowners? So right option for this question is Velalar. Velalar. Okay. Next question is according to the Manusmriti. Look at the question of Manusmriti. Women can acquire wealth through which of the following means? So, women can acquire wealth through the token of affection. Okay, this is the condition of, this is through Manusmriti, according to Manusmriti. Okay, women can't acquire wealth through inheritance or purchase or investment. They cannot purchase their land. They can acquire wealth through only token of affection. The dialogue on Varna between King Avantiput and Kachana, a disciple of Buddha, appears in which one of the following Buddhist texts? The dialogue on Varna between King Avantiput and Kachana, a disciple of Buddha, appears in which one of the following Buddhist texts? So the option for this question is A, Majjhima Nikaya. Okay. Next question is, in the first century AD, which among the following was not a major item of Indian exports to Rome? So right option for this question is spikenard. Okay, so we used to export paper or tortoise shell or nutmeg, but we was not exporting the spikenard. Okay, next question is, which of the following statements relating to the Government of India Act 1858 is correct? Government of India Act 1858. So it was the act after freedom struggle 1857, very famous freedom struggle. Okay, so the British Crown assumed sovereignty over India from the East India Company. Obviously this is true. The British Parliament enacted the first statute for the governance of India under the direct rule of the British. So this also seems right. This act was dominated by the principle of absolute imperial control without any popular participation in the administration of the country. This act was dominated by the principle of absolute imperial control without any popular participation in the administration of the country. This is also true. So right option is C. 1, 2 and 3, all of them are correct. So this is about Government of India Act 1858. Next question is, which of the following statements relating to the Indian Council Act 1861 is are correct? Indian Council Act 1861. So let's read the option. The act introduced a grain of popular element by including non-official members in the Governor General's Executive Council. This is true. Indian Council Act 1861 introduced a grain of popular element by including non-official members in the Governor General's Executive Council. This is right. The members were nominated and their functions were confined exclusively to the consideration of legislative proposals placed before it by the Governor General. So this is also right. So second option is also right. Third one is, the Governor General did not have effective legislative power. No, this is not true. He had the power of veto. So one and two option is right. Okay, so A option is right. Okay, next question is, which of the following statements relating to the historic objective resolution, Historic Objectives Resolution, which was adopted by the Constituent Assembly, is are correct? So options are, let's read the option. Options are, the objective resolution inspired the shaping of Constitution through all its subsequent stages. So this is right. It was not just a resolution, but a declaration, a firm resolve, and a pledge. So this also seems right. It provided the underlying philosophy of our constitution. So this is also right. So this objective resolution, all of the options are right. So option C must be right. Okay. Next question is, the 2+2 bilateral dialogue was held in September 2018 between. So obviously you know about this, about India, between India and USA. So options are, A option is correct, obviously. External affairs, but you have to remember which 2 and 2 plus 2. So these two ministries are External Affairs Ministry and Defense Ministry of India with their US counterparts. Okay, so option A is right. Next question is, who is the chairman of Defense Planning Committee? Chairman of Defense Planning Committee set up in April 2018. So right option for this question is National Security Advisor. So National Security Advisor, our National Security Advisor is the Chairman of Defense Planning Committee. Or who is the National Security Advisor? Mr. Ajit Doval, Senior IPS Officer. Okay. Next question is, Tejas. Tejas is the name of which one of the following? Tejas is name of which one of the following? So Tejas is name of light combat aircraft. So Tejas is the name of light combat aircraft. As per the extant policy, Foreign direct investment is permitted in the defense sector under the automatic route up to which one of the following limits? This is a very important question actually. You have to remember this question later on also. So right option for this question is D, 49%. So in the defense sector under the automatic route up to 49% is allowed. Okay. Next question is, the policy and strategic partnership in defense was approved by the Ministry of Defense in May 2017. Which of the following is not among the four segments identified by the Ministry of Acquisition through the strategic partnership route? So tell which one is not included. So options are artillery guns, fighter aircraft and helicopters, submarines, armored fighting vehicles and main battle tanks. So right option is artillery guns. So artillery guns is not among the four segments. And rest are included fighter aircrafts and helicopters, submarines and armored fighting vehicles and main battle tanks. Acronym CATSA refers to piece of legislation enacted by which one of the following countries? So obviously you know this very simple question. This is by United States of America. Who among the following is the convener of the task force set up in the November 2017 by the Government of India to review the Income Tax Act and draft a new direct tax law? When the following is the convener of task force set up in the November 2017 by the Government of India to review the Income Tax Act and draft a new direct tax law? So red option is Arvind Modi. Okay. He is the convener of the task force. Next question is, with regard to cabinet decision in July 2018, the percentage increased in minimum support price is maximum in which one of the following crops? So right option is A, jowar, hybrid jowar. Okay. Now these are directions, assertion and reasoning. So you know what is option A, both the statements are individually true and statement 2 is the correct explanation. And second one, both statements are true but explanation is not correct. And C is statement 1 is true but statement 2 is false. And D is statement 1 is false but statement 2 is true. So let's start with the 72nd question. So the statement is, the overall fiscal deficit of the state in India during 2017-18 stayed above the fiscal responsibility and budget management threshold level of 3% for the third successive year. So this is true. That's true. And reasoning is, statement 2 is, special category states had run up a higher level of fiscal deficit in 2017-18 compared to 2016-17. And that is the perfect reason for that. Because of special category states, the fiscal deficit raised beyond 3%, and that 3% was targeted by Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, FRBM Act. Okay. Next question is, there has been a sharp decline in the saving rates in Indian economy between 2007-2008 to 2015-16. So that's also true. There is sharp decline, yeah. Second one is, there has been a fall in household and public savings. Yeah, because of that fall in household and public savings, that fall occurred. Okay, so both statements are true and A option is right. And in the above question, 72nd, A option is also true. Okay. So A option is right over here. 74th question is, private investment in research have severely lagged public investment in India. So private investment in research have severely lagged public investment in India. That's true. Private investment in research have not taken place the way it should have. And second option is, universities plays a relatively small role in the research activities of the country. No, universities plays a vital role actually. So statement 2 is wrong. Okay. And statement 1 is right. So C option must be right. Okay. C option is right over there. Next question is, agriculture in India accounts for a substantial share in total employment. Obviously, not a substantial, a huge amount, almost 45%+, approximately 50%. Second option is there has been no decline in volatility of agriculture growth in India. There has been no decline. Obviously, there is decline. There is decline in volatility. Now volatility is a little less. Okay. So C option is right. Only A statement 1 is correct only. Okay. Next question is, Who among the following European travelers never returned to Europe and settled down in India? So it's Manuki. Okay. Manuki settled down in India. So please remember this very important question. Manuki settled down in India. Next question is, the class of Amar Nayaks in Vijayanagara is a reference to which of the following? So class of Amar Nayaks in Vijayanagara is a reference of military commanders. Okay. Amar Nayak, military commander. The important source of Akbar's reign, Tehreek-e-Akbari, was written by which one of the following Persian language scholar? So right option for this question is Arif Kandhari. Okay. So Arif Kandhari wrote Tehreek-e-Akbari. Okay. Next question is, the aristocrat Mukarrab Khan was a great favorite of which Mughal emperor? So he was favorite of Jahangir. So Mukarrab Khan. Okay. Who was the first Nawab, Wazir of Awadh in the 18th century? First Nawab Wazir of Awadh in 18th century. So it's Nawab Saadat Ali Khan. Okay. According to the French traveler Tavernier, the majority of houses in Varanasi during the 17th century were made of. So were made of brick and mud. Okay. So many questions from history came this year. Which of the following statements relating to the duties of governor is are correct? So options are, let's study the options. So the duties of the governor as a constitutional head of the state do not become the subject matter of questions of debate in the parliament. No, this is not right. This does not seem right. Where the governor takes a decision independently of his council of ministers, or where he acts as a chief executive of a state under president's rule, his actions are subject to scrutiny by the parliament. Yeah, that is possible. So right option is B, 2 only. Okay. Which one of the following articles? Actually, governor is not acting like a chief justice or justice in the High Court or Supreme Court, because their acts cannot be discussed in the parliament or state legislature. But governor's act can be discussed. Which of the following, 83rd question is, which one of the following articles of the Constitution of India deals with the special provisions with respect to the state of Assam? Actually, these days, special provisions are asked in almost all kind of exams. So please remember all special provisions about the all states. Okay. So about Assam, it's Article 371B. And 370, I think you know that. It's about Jammu and Kashmir. Provision of which one of the following articles of the Constitution of India apply to the state of Jammu and Kashmir? Look at here. Article 370. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग शेड्यूल्स टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया प्रोवाइड्स फॉर सेटिंग अप ऑफ ऑटोनॉमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल. ऑटोनॉमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल इट वॉज अंडर सिक्स शेड्यूल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट्स वॉज डिफेंस एक्सपो कॉल्ड एज डेफ एक्सपो 2018 हेल्ड इन अप्रैल 2018. सो राइट ऑप्शन इज तमिलनाडु. ओके द टू डिफेंस इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर्स announced by the finance minister in his 2018 budget speech are coming up in which of the following states? So right option is Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Okay. What is India's first indigenous aircraft carrier called? Vikrant. Vikrant is India's first indigenous aircraft carrier. Vikrant. Please remember this. Which one of the following manufacturers is engaged in upgradation of Swedish 155mm Bofors Hodger under the project Dhanush? So this is Ordnance Factory Board. Okay. Which one of the following is the official mascot of Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games? And that is Miratoa. Miratoa. Okay. So Miratoa is the official mascot of Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. Next question is Mission Satyanishtha, a program on ethics in public governance, was launched recently by the Indian Railway. Mission Satyanishtha. The College of Fort William. College of Fort William was established by which one of the following Governor Generals? So College of Fort William was established by the Richard Wellesley. Okay, Richard Wellesley established the Fort William College. The economic historian who has used the data collected by the Buchanan Hamilton to support the thesis of deindustrialization in the 19th century, India is. So, it's Tirthankar Rai. Tirthankar Rai used the data collected by the Buchanan Hamilton to support the thesis of deindustrialization in the 19th century, India. Next question is, tea growing in India in the 19th century was made possible by? It was made possible by Robert Fortune. Next question is, Subhash Chandra Bose started the Azad Hind Radio in which of the following country? This is important question. He started Azad Hind Radio in Germany. Which political party formally accepted the cabinet mission plan on 6 June 1946? Which had rejected the demand for sovereign Pakistan? So, right option for this is Congress. So, Congress formally accepted the cabinet mission plan but rejected the demand of sovereign Pakistan. The elected president of All India Kisan Sabha, which met in Vijayawada in 1944, was. So, elected president of All India Kisan Sabha in the Vijayawada session was Sajanand Saraswati. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following regarding the tenure of the elected members of the Autonomous District Council is correct? So, right option is 5 years from the date appointed for the first meeting of the council after the election. Who in the following shall cause the accounts of the autonomous district and regional council funds to be audited? So, it's the Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Next question is, who has the power of annulment or suspension of acts and resolution of Autonomous District and Regional Council? So many questions from Autonomous District and Regional Council because this is a question of CDS. So who has the power of annulment? So power of annulment rests with the governor. Next question is, the audit reports of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India relating to the accounts of the union shall be submitted to. So shall be submitted to the president. Next question is, which of the following is not related to the powers of governor? Not related to the powers of governor. So it's a diplomatic and military powers, obviously. But he, what he does, he have power to appoint advocate general. He can summon, prorogue and dissolve state legislature. He have power to grant pardons, reprieves, respites or remission of punishments. Which one of the following regarding the procedure and conduct of business in parliament is not correct? So let's see the options. To discuss state matters regarding the procedure and conduct of business in parliament is not correct. So to discuss the state matters, no. Parliament does not discuss the state matters. They discuss the union matters. So this option must be right. And what they does, to discuss issues of the use of police force in suppressing the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes communities. To discuss issues in dealing with the violent disturbances in an undertaking under the control of union government, obviously. To discuss issues by for putting down the demands of the industrial labor. That's also right. So what is not discussed? To discuss state matters. They don't discuss. Why they will discuss state matters? That is the state subject. Next question is, which of the following is not under the powers and function of Election Commission of India? So let's see. Superintendence, direction, control of the preparation of electoral rolls. Obviously, it's under their control. Conduct of election to the parliament and to the legislature of the state, that is also under their control. Conduct of election to the office of the president and vice president, that is also under their control. Appointment of the regional commissioner to assist the election commission in the performance of the function conferred on the commission, that's not under their control. Okay. Regional commissioners are not appointed by them. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following criteria is not required to be qualified for the appointment as judge of Supreme Court? Okay. So, at least 5 years as judge of High Court, obviously, that's criteria. At least 10 years as advocate of High Court, that's also criteria. In the opinion of the president, a distinguished jurist, that's also a criteria. At least 20 years as sub judice magistrate, no, this is not a criteria. And next question is, which one of the following is not among the duties of the Chief Minister? Not among the duties of Chief Minister. So, to communicate to the Governor of the state all decisions of the Council of Ministers relating to the administration of the affairs of the state and proposals for legislation. So, this is what Chief Minister have to do. Even the Prime Minister have to do with the Governor, President. Okay. Second is to furnish information relating to the administration of the state and proposals for legislation as the governor may call for. So that's also, this is what Chief Minister does. C option is to communicate to the president all decisions of the Council of Ministers relating to the administration of the state in the monthly report. No, this is not what they does. Chief Minister need not to do that. Okay. D option is to submit for the consideration of the Council of Ministers any matter on which a decision has been taken by a minister but has not been considered by the council if the governor so requires. So this is what Chief Minister does. Okay. So C option is not right. Next question is, which one of the following is not considered a part of legislature of the state? Governor, he is a part of legislature. Legislative assembly, obviously. Legislative assembly is a part of. This legislative council, that's a part of legislature. The Chief Minister. No, Chief Minister is not part of legislature actually. They don't have anything to do with that. Actually, Chief Minister as the MLA, Member of Legislative Assembly, he's a part of legislature. But chief minister as independent body is not a part of legislature. Okay. Which one of the following regarding the ordinance making power of the governor is not correct? Okay. So, it is not a discretionary power. It is not a discretionary power. That's true. The governor may withdraw the ordinance anytime. That's also possible. The ordinance power can be exercised when the legislature is not in session. That's obviously, that's the reason of ordinance. And D option is the aid and advice of minister is not required for declaring the ordinance. No. Aid and advice of only ministers is required for the declaring the ordinance. Governor cannot do it in its own. Okay. Governor need the advice of minister only then governor can implement the ordinance. Okay. Next question is, which one of the following statements regarding the Universal Declaration of Human Rights is not correct? The UN General Assembly adopted the Human Rights Charter on 10th December 1948. Yes, they have accepted the Human Rights Charter on 10th December 1948. Some of the provisions of the fundamental rights enshrined in the Constitution of India are similar to the provisions of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. That's also true. The right to property is not a part of Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Actually, the right to property is the part of Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So this is not correct. So, and last option is India is signatory to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Obviously, India is signatory. Next question is, which one of the following statements regarding to the Human Rights Council is not correct? Okay. So, you have to tell the wrong option. Okay. It is an intergovernmental body within the United Nations system made up of all members of United Nations. No, not all members of United Nations. So, this seems not correct. It is responsible for the promotion and protection of all human rights around the globe. Yes, this is true. It replaced the former United Nations Commission on Human Rights. Yes, it replaced the United Nations Commission on Human Rights and now it is called as a Human Rights Council. Okay. It is made up of 47 UN member states which are elected by the UN General Assembly. That's also true. 47 United Nations member states which are elected by the UN General Assembly. That's also true. Okay. Next question is, as athlete Neeraj Chopra is an accomplished player in the field of, so he is in the javelin throw. Obviously, Neeraj Chopra, very popular player, javelin throw. According to the updated World Bank data for 2017, India is the sixth biggest economy of the world in the terms of GDP. Which of the following is not ahead of India? So, Japan. Japan is obviously ahead of India. UK is ahead of India. France is not the ahead of India. Okay. Right now, France is not ahead of India. Next question is, which of the following is correct about Aayakar Setu? About Aayakar Setu. You have to tell the right option. It is a mechanism for achieving excellence in public sector delivery related to GST. No. With the use of mobile app, it facilitates online payment of taxes. Yeah, that's true. Aayakar Setu. This is what Aayakar Setu is about. With the use of mobile app, it facilitates online payment of taxes. Okay. Swayam is. So, Swayam is a network that aims to tap the talent pool of scientists and entrepreneurs towards global excellence. No. Swayam is a massive open online course. Yes, this is a massive open online course initiative on national platform. So, it is a massive open online course. Okay. Initiative on the national platform. So, this is about Swayam. Okay. And next question is, under the Prasad Tourism Scheme, Prashad Tourism Scheme, which one of the following has not been identified as a religious site for the development? So it's Haridwar. Rest Ajmer, Somnath and Velankani has been identified as a religious site, but Haridwar Uttarakhand is not identified as a religious site for development. Okay. Under the Prashad Tourism Scheme. Okay. Next option is, name the Indian cricketer who is not inducted to the ICC Cricket Hall of the Fame till July 2018. So options are Rahul Dravid, he is already inducted. Sunil Gavaskar, he is inducted. Sachin Tendulkar. Actually, Sachin Tendulkar who is not inducted. And rest are inducted. Okay. The Central Water Commission, CWC, has recently entered into a collaborative agreement with which one of the following entities of flood forecasting? So, options are SkyMet, Google, Met Service, AccuWeather. So, your option is Google. The Central Water Commission has recently entered into a collaborative agreement with Google for the flood forecasting. Okay. Next question is, the tagline "Invaluable Treasures of Incredible India" is associated with the logo for. So right option for this question is geographical indication tag, GI tag. Okay. The tagline "Invaluable Treasures of Incredible India" is associated with the GI, geographical indications of India. Next question is, who took over the Eka movement started by the Congress in Awadh during 1921-22? So right option is Madari Passi. Okay, so Madari Passi took over the Eka movement started by the Congress in Awadh. And last question is, which organization was started at the Haridwar Kumbh Mela in 1915? So right option for this question is Hindu Mahasabha started at the Haridwar Kumbh Mela in 1915. So that's all for this video, and the next video I'll talk about another topic. Till then, thank you so much for watching my video, and please do not forget to hit like and subscribe button. Thank you so much. Bye bye, take care.